Hello children, I welcome you all once again to your English class. I hope you all are doing fine. Children, for today's English lesson, we are going to start a new chapter from your Honeysuckle book, A Game of Chance. And this story is on page number 99. Okay, you know children, sometimes we try our luck into some things like a game. Maybe some like you want to take the chance that whether you win or lose. So we will read about a boy, Rashid, okay, and how he tries his luck somewhere, and we will see whether he wins or lose the chance, okay. So let's get started by reading the story. Every year on the occasion of Eid, there was a fair in our village. So children, you see, there is a fair organized when? On every Eid, okay. So you know that this Eid is the principal festival celebrated in Muslims, okay. They celebrate it. It's a really festive time for them. So there was this fair, you know, that Mela kind of thing. Yes, so they had their village. In the village, they had this fair where this which actually took place when? Which took place during Eid. Eid was celebrated only one day, but the fair lasted many days. Yes, the day that Eid came was only for one day, obviously you know it. But this fair lasted, means it survived what? It was continuous for a long time. It went on for a long time. Tradesmen from far and wide came there with all kind of goods to sell. Yes, so why was it popular? Because everyone came with their different goods to sell. Okay, now we see you could buy anything from a small pin to a big buffalo. Yes, what did they bring? They brought a lot of things with them. The businessmen, the people who came to sold their things in the fair, they brought a lot of things. Uncle took me to the fair. Bhaiya, who worked for us at home, so there was this help, domestic help, we see. So there was this domestic help who used to help in the work, in the household. Uncle, who took him to the fair, who took Rashid to the fair? His uncle. Okay. Now, Bhaiya, who worked for us at home, came with us. There was a big crowd at the fair. So who went along with Uncle and Rashid? The bhaiya, the domestic help who used to help in the household work. Now, uncle was leading us through the crowd when he met a few of his friends. So, what happened here? Yes, uncle took Rashid to the fair, and when he was taking Rashid into the fair, he met the uncle, met his few friends, okay? Now, they wanted him to spend some time with them. The friends whom the uncle met, they wanted to spend some time with whom? With uncle. Now, uncle asked me whether I would like to look around the fair with Bhaiya till he came back. So, uncle told Rashid that you may look around, you may find exciting things. And who was given the charge of Rashid? The bhaiya, the domestic help, okay. So he was going to look after Rashid till then he came back. I was happy to do that. Uncle warned me neither to buy anything nor to go too far out while he was away. I promised that I would wait for him. So what did he want? He said that you're not going to buy anything in my absence, and also you're not going too far away. You have to stay around only. You're not going too far away. Now, so obviously he was a good child. So Rashid followed, means the narrator followed the uncle's command, and he thought that he won't be misbehaving. He promised that he won't go far as well. Now, Bhaiya and I went from shop to shop. Now they were like window shopping kind of thing. They were roaming around. They were looking at shops. There were many things I would have liked to buy, but I waited for uncle to return. Then we came to see what was called the lucky shop. So they were looking at many shops, and then what happened? They found what? A shop which was called what? Lucky Shop. Yes, you must remember this name, children. Now, with this, the shopkeeper was neither young nor old. He was a middle-aged man. Okay, he seemed neither too smart nor too lazy. So, the shopkeeper was a middle-aged man. Okay, he neither looked too active nor looked too lazy. So, we see here that he wanted everybody to try their luck. Yes, you know, children, I told you when I was starting the chapter that sometimes it happens that you want to try your luck into something. Yes, whether you win or lose. Maybe if you haven't done your homework, you want to go to school and you decide to go to school. Maybe teacher won't be checking it right now. So you attempt a gamble. You want to try your luck. So here we see that the shopkeeper, that lucky shop's shopkeeper, he was wanting what? He was wanting for everyone to try their luck. There were discs on the table with numbers from 1 to 10 facing down. So there was this disc, okay, you might have seen it. There was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to 10, up to 10 the number was written. All you had to do was to pay 50 paise and then pick up any 6 disc. Okay, so there was this disc which was marked from 1 to 10. Add up the numbers on the disc and find the total. So what was to do? You have to choose any 6 disc. You have to find the total. And the total will be added up. And the thing which is there in the total will be yours. Okay, when you add up the total. So easy game, right? 50 paise and you get so many things. So here now see, the article marked with that number was yours. Okay, so yes, everyone wanted to try their luck. Now let's see what happened. We are on page 100 and 101. We will see there what happens. An old man paid 50 paise and selected 6 discs. So the number disc which were given numbers like 1, 2, 3 to 10, right? He added up the numbers on them and found the total was 15. So when he took the 6 disc, he got 15. And he was given the article marked 15. What was the article? Which was a beautiful clock. But the old man did not want a clock. So this old man did not want a clock. What did he do? He sold the clock to the shopkeeper again. We will see. The shopkeeper obliged him by buying it back for 15 rupees. He said, okay, you don't need the clock. I am paying you 15 rupees. You give me this clock. The old man went away very pleased. He said, okay, so I gave 50 paise and I want this clock, but I don't want this clock anymore. And then he even got 15 rupees and he went happily. Then a boy, a little older than I. So this narrator is actually telling us the story. So a boy came there again. He was little bit older. I tried his luck. He got a comb worth 25 paise. The shopkeeper looked neither happy nor sad. He bought the comb from the boy for 25 paise. The boy tried his luck again. He now got a fountain pen worth 3 rupees. Then he tried a third time and got a wrist watch worth rupees 25. When he tried again, he got a table lamp worth more than 10 rupees. The boy was really happy and went away with a smile and a good deal of cash. So everything that the boy won was given back to the shopkeeper. Means he bought it again and we can see that he was very pleased. He was very happy with his luck. Okay, so we see that the old man also went away with some cash and here this boy also went with some cash. I wanted to try my luck too. Okay, this created a kind of, you can say, curiosity, or you can say that he also was tempted to try his luck. So here, I wanted to try my luck too. I looked at Bhaiya. So he looked at Bhaiya that, Bhaiya, I want to try my luck in this game of chance. And now he encouraged me. He said, yes, yes, you can win. I paid 50 paise and took 6 discs. My luck was not too good. I got 2 pencils. The shopkeeper bought them from me for 25 paise. I tried again. This time I got a bottle of ink, also of little value. The shopkeeper bought that too for 25 paisa. I took a third chance for the third time. Still, luck was not with me. Okay, so this boy, this narrator, wasn't winning anything, and even when he won, the three items that he won was a very cheap price. Okay, now again the shopkeeper showed his kindness. Now you see, I had hopes of winning a big prize and continued to try my luck again and again. He kept on paying 50 paise and he tried to buy, paying 50 paise each time. But every time I got a truffle. Truffle is what, children? A thing of small value. A thing which is of small value. Again, the shopkeeper showed his kindness. He said I could either play once more with 25 paise or settle the account then and there. He said you can play with 25 paise or you can just take these things and you can go now. I played again and the last 25 paise also disappeared. Okay, so he kept on playing. So that 25 paisa that he won also were gone now. Okay, so you see that the narrator's luck wasn't favoring him much. Yes, now let's see. People were looking at me. Some were laughing at my bad luck. So the narrator saw what? That the people around him, because you know he was failing so many times, his luck was not helping him anywhere. Now, some were laughing, some were very sympathetic. Okay, they were showing sympathy that bichara, he could not win. Okay, like that. Bhaiya and I went to the place where uncle had left us and waited for him to return. Yes, so now obviously with this ill luck, with this bad luck, they returned to the same place where uncle had left them. Presently he came, he looked at me and said, Rashid, you look upset. What is the matter? So when he came back, when the uncle returned after meeting, after talking with his friends, he looked at what? He looked at Rashid's face. He was what? He was very much sad now. With this, presently he came, he looked at me and said, Rashid, you looked upset. What is the matter? I did not say anything. Bhaiya told him what had happened. So the domestic help, Bhaiya told him everything. Uncle was neither angry nor sad. Okay, he wasn't angry, he wasn't disappointed. He smiled and patted me. He took me to a shop and bought me a beautiful umbrella, biscuits and sweets and some other little gifts. Then we returned home. Okay, now let's see what happened. So he bought him some small gifts, little gifts, and then the three of them, Bhaiya, Uncle and Rashid, returned home. Okay. Now we see also he bought some like a beautiful umbrella, biscuits and sweets for Rashid and some other little gifts. Now back home, uncle told me that the lucky shop man had made a fool of me. Yes, made a fool means bevakoof banana, to make you stupid. Okay, now made a fool means cheated here. Okay, so you can see that uncle told Rashid that you were cheated. Let's see how. No, uncle, I said it was just my bad luck. So Rashid was very sure that it was his bad luck, that's why he could not win any prize. No, my boy, said uncle, it was neither good luck nor bad luck. But uncle, I said I saw an old man getting a clock and a boy getting two or three costly things. So he said, I saw this old man, he won a beautiful clock. And then I had seen what? I had seen a boy, he won two or three costly items. You don't know, child, uncle said. They were all friends of the shopkeeper. They were playing tricks to tempt you. Okay, here tempt means to draw you, attract your attention. To tempt you to try your luck. They wanted your money and they got it. Now forget about it and don't tell anybody of your bad luck or your foolishness. Okay, so uncle said they cheated you. How? The old man and the little boy were the friends of whom? Were the friends of this shopkeeper. This shopkeeper actually tempted you, attracted you to try your luck, and this way he got your money. Okay, so you see how this works. Now, I hope you understood, children. And see, there is nothing like something bad luck or good luck. Until and unless you work hard, children, unless and until you don't work hard, you won't achieve any success. Okay, so you should know that these things, which are sometimes you think that they are winning it, why am I not winning it? So it can be like, it can be that they are trying to cheat you. Yeah, so with this, you see that we have finish this chapter, and we will be doing the meanings first. Now let's get started with the meanings for today. The first word is occasion. So the word meanings, children, let's write it down. Number one, occasion. It means festival. Number two, celebrated. Performed or observed. Number three, tradesman. Shopkeepers. Number four, leading, taking. Number five, discs, round plates. Number six, luck, fate. Other word for luck is fate. Number seven, obliged, favored. When you do someone some favor, so favored. Number eight, trifle. A thing of small value. Yes, children. Now, settle the accounts then and there. Number nine, settle the accounts. Finish at once. Number 10, sympathy. Sympathy means feeling of being sorry. Number 11, made a fool of me. Cheated me. Number 12, tempt. Tempt means
draw or attract.
Okay children, so we are done with the meanings. Please take a screenshot quickly. We are done with this chapter's meanings now. In our next video lesson, we are going to attempt the book exercise. Okay, we are going to attempt the textbook questions. Okay, so for this video children, we are ending it here only. Take care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye.